I became an athletic trainer. I just have a real passion for helping people, and I had been a collegiate athlete myself, made lots of mistakes and lots of injuries, and it was an opportunity for me to help others and try to prevent some of the injuries that pretty much plague high school and collegiate athletes. Well, I was very frustrated early on in my career because I realized that there just wasn't a lot of information out there. Athletic training was an evolving field, and it still is. And so from a science and medicine standpoint, a lot of times athletes don't really get access to the information that they need early in their career to make the right kinds of choices. And they're dependent upon others, and quite often those others are non-credentialed, non-licensed folks that are well-intended but really uninformed about what's appropriate for people and what's safe for them as far as participation, in particular following an injury. Well, one of the wonderful things about the athletic training profession is that it's an ever-evolving science. You know, the sports medicine is just such an enjoyable, passionate field to work in, partly because of the challenges that are there. I mean, we're in a very unique field in that the information age, especially now with the computers and the electronic media, allows us access to so much information. And you know, we want to make sure that information is accurate and that we're using it in a very positive way to help benefit the folks that we're responsible for, our athletes, whether it's the high school, collegiate, or professional level folks. Athletic training is a very demanding profession, not only from a time management standpoint. You know, in the traditional model, athletic trainers are the first ones there and the last ones to leave, and then you have all the administrative duties and follow-ups. It's really, from a time management standpoint, a very challenging job. But even in the allied health professions, in the non-traditional fields, athletic trainers are playing vital roles in the healthcare paradigm and the way that healthcare is delivered, in particular in the clinical settings, in the non-traditional clinical settings, whether it's outpatient physical therapy or in concussion clinics or in doctor's offices. You know, the ACT is physician extenders and case managers, and it's a very time-consuming process. And one of the most important parts about this job is being a good communicator. And so we find ourselves in a position to sometimes where we're acting as quasi case managers to make sure that everybody's on the same page when it comes to the health and safety of our athletes and the patients that we're responsible for. Concussion management is an emerging field in our profession. And in order to really manage the health and safety of our athletes and our patients best, we have to interact with other professions. The other allied health professionals for sure, but also physicians, because quite often they don't really have the time to follow up with their patients in an appropriate manner. And one of the things we know, everybody's busy right now. So quite often, especially with a concussion patient, they're gonna be seen by 2, 3, 4 different people. And if we're not all on the same page and we're all not communicating well, the patient's the one that suffers. So interacting with the other allied health professionals and the physicians, it really needs to be one person that can help do that. And you know, athletic trainers are great navigators in the concussion world. And part of it is just because of our organizational skills. You know, we're used to keeping track of what's going on with our athletes and used to documenting what's happening. Generally speaking, very good communicators when it comes to talking with physicians. Now we just need to include a couple other people into that scope, and that's, you know, whether it's the neuropsychologist or the physical therapist or the neurooptometrist, it's a team approach, but there needs to be a leader. And I call it everybody playing in the sandbox well together. It makes it much easier on the patient, and actually they benefit greatly when that athletic trainer has those good organizational and administrative skills. We just see them progress so much quicker through the system. The ITAT program, which is for athletic trainers, the ImPACT Train Athletic Trainers program, has been a huge benefit, partly because it keeps me current on what's going on in the profession, all the new things that ImPACT is doing to help their customers use it in a manner that's designed to use. And as athletic trainers, sometimes we like to improvise and cut corners, because it's just easier that way for us dealing with our athletes. And with the ITAT program in particular, it's a systematic process that it teaches us as athletic trainers on how to use ImPACT and how to implement it appropriately at our school or our clinic so that we don't make mistakes and that we actually are doing some things to facilitate, you know, valid, reliable results when we're doing testing, and also to understanding the appropriate way to use it from a post-injury standpoint is really important. So for a new athletic trainer, the ITAT program is really an ideal opportunity for them to get up-to-date information about what's happening in concussion management. You know, we encourage all of our new students, those folks that are newly certified, to go ahead and take the time to study for, go to the course, take the ITAT certification, because it's going to help them, especially if they're going to be working in a traditional field at the school sites, because many schools still don't understand the right way to use ImPACT. And if you have the certification, now you've got a roadmap for how to implement the program, you know, how to communicate with the other professionals that might come in contact with your student athletes, and most importantly, how to understand what the outcomes should be. You know, when is it appropriate to write guidelines for return to play, or when to do academic accommodations? Those are the kinds of things that are covered in the course, and they're very important for a young athletic trainer to understand when it comes to getting that first job or getting out into the school site. The second part that I think is really important about it, aside from the preparation, is if we look at what's happening to athletic training as an emerging field, and especially when it comes to concussion management, there's just no person better suited to be a concussion clinic navigator or to coordinate programs than the certified athletic trainer. And it gets back to our training and our background and our experiences that we have. And, you know, the last part is that certifications are important, because in order to get them, you have to work at something. And with the state of our profession now, we're trying to make sure that everything is evidence-based. We're treating our athletes for a reason, because clinically, it's the most responsible, appropriate thing for them to do. So obviously, you know, we're big advocates of the ITAT program. I think ImPACT has done a wonderful job putting the course together. And the other thing that makes it very unique is the Con Ed requirement that very few certifications have. So it's more than just taking the course and becoming ITAT certified. It's now incumbent upon that person to stay current with what's going on in the field. And ImPACT offers courses and webinars that are readily available and accessible to allow that athletic trainer to stay current with what's going on. So when I refer to the right way of using the ImPACT program, what we really mean is to use the program the way it was designed. Quite often, athletic trainers are, you know, we're looking to get our athletes back out there quicker. That's the whole thing. It's, you know, there is a lot of pressure on us to return people to play quickly, get them back to school. Aside from the parental pressure and the coaching pressure, it's the pressure that the athlete puts on us to want to get them back in there quicker. So if we aren't using the ImPACT program correctly, then it's not an appropriate tool and it can be misused. And one of the ways that we see that is when athletic trainers are doing serial post-injury ImPACT tests, sometimes three or four in the same week when someone's been concussed, and thinking that, well, I'm looking for these numbers. What numbers are you looking for? When it's used appropriately, it's a wonderful clinical tool that gives us tremendous information about how our athletes are doing. And it also helps the other allied health professionals that are involved with the treatment and care of that athlete understand the basis for our plan of care moving forward. So that's what I mean when we talk about the appropriate use of ImPACT. ImPACT is very easily administered, but there does need to be a protocol that's followed. And the reason that we follow that protocol is because we want to have valid, accurate, reliable tests. And it can be quite challenging when you're testing 50, 60, 100 athletes at once, a lot of times in a library or a computer lab. If the athletic trainer does not understand how to appropriately administer that test, and also looks at those tests after they're done to see whether or not they're valid, they could miss something. And we just don't want to miss things when it comes to the health and safety of our athletes. So it's very easily administered. Fortunately, most athletes are very computer savvy these days, so they understand about how to use the computer. It's just incumbent upon us to make sure we have everything set up right, especially in a mass testing situation. You know, we want to make sure that it's conducive to getting good results. And this is where the cueing that ImPACT gives the clinician prior to administering the test it's just a nice reminder that, hey, let's make sure we have a good environment that is quiet, that everybody's using a external mouse on the computers, and that they're logging in appropriately, and that they're following the guidelines and procedures that we know are going to be very effective for getting valid tests. So athletes are very curious about ImPACT, and I think part of it is just there's still some misconceptions about what the test is and does. So, you know, quite often we actually get significant test anxiety, similar to what they would get taking their exams in high school or college. And so, you know, I think that's one of the biggest things, you know, what if I don't pass? I hear that one all the time. So we have to remind them that, you know, that's not what ImPACT is about, that there is no pass-fail on this test, that there's no grades. We just want you to have a valid, reliable test. And that means, one, you have to turn your cell phone off. You've got to not talk to your buddy, your friend next to you that's taking the test. You know, we do want you to be attentive to what the instructions are on the screen and respond appropriately. And we also tell them it is important that you have a valid, reliable test. You know, those are the tenets by which the whole baseline testing system works. So if the athlete understands that, they actually really buy into doing it right. And the other part is them knowing that, you know, why we're using it. The videos that ImPACT has put together have been very, very helpful. You can show those before you give the tests. We do a little tutorial before we do any testing so that the athletes know this is what ImPACT is, this is what it isn't, this is what we're going to use it for, this is not how it's going to be used. Your ability to return to play is not going to be based upon how you do on your ImPACT test. It's a tool that we use that helps us determine when it's appropriate for you to progress through your return to play program, return to school program, whether or not we need to bring in some extra additional academic help from the school. That's what ImPACT is all about. Concussion management before ImPACT was very confusing. You know, we had lots of different governing bodies that all had their rules and definitions for what a concussion was. We graded concussions. There were different classification systems determined based on really what group you worked with, if it was American College of Sports Medicine guidelines or the National Athletic Training guidelines or American College of Pediatrics. So there was some confusion, and part of the problem with that was that athletic trainers from different parts of the country seeing different kinds of athletes, sometimes our interpretation scales weren't standard. So if you have an athlete that's moving from high school to college or college to the pros, or, you know, has been fairly nomadic and at the club level, we don't always know what their status is, what they've had access to testing wise. So, you know, ImPACT has really been a game changer in our profession. And while there's other programs out there, you know, to have a program like ImPACT with as much data as we have in the database now available to us as clinicians, it just makes it so much easier as a clinical tool to use it with our athletes. That's, to me, been the most important part of it. Well, we deal with a lot of school districts that are not using ImPACT. And here in California, we also deal with a lot of school districts that don't have certified athletic trainers on campus. It's not a requirement here, unfortunately. So while we're working very hard at that, the school districts still have the responsibility of providing a safe atmosphere and environment for student athletes to compete. And quite often we'll get a call saying, we want you to come help us set up our concussion program, but, you know, we have no budget available, or, you know, we're using a local physician and they're not knowledgeable about what's going on in the concussion field. So, you know, we've been driven mostly in the compliance area with the school districts because of the medical legal liabilities that have been involved. So school districts now, because of the potential of being sued, are now struggling to design programs. And, you know, unfortunately, a lot of school districts still do not have written concussion plans of care in place. They don't have emergency action plans in place. They don't know how to dovetail those two to make it into a program that's going to be really safe for their athletes. So a lot of times they look at ImPACT as the answer. And I applaud them when they ask us, you know, can you help us get ImPACT on campus? Absolutely, we can do that. But we also want to teach you how to use it appropriately. And I think that that's the most important part of it, is not only using it appropriately, but having someone involved with the district or the school that knows how to use ImPACT. And that's where the certifications are so vital. It's nice to be able to tell somebody, look, you can go on the ImPACT website, find a provider that can help interpret your baseline testing, that can help you guide you through the process, that can proctor your tests for you. The school districts have responded very favorably to that. And you know, the next step is really what we're all here for, and that's protecting our kids and our athletes so that they can return to play, return to school, and do so in a really timely fashion. I've been using ImPACT now for about 8 years, 8-9 years. So we have a lot of very successful recoveries, you know, lots of success stories, I'm happy to say. I think the most important part is that with our patients leave, whether it's the concussion clinic or they leave the formal setting where ImPACT has been used as a tool, they have a much greater understanding about the nature of their injury and ways they can prevent it moving forward. And they've also become very good healthcare consumers. They understand now that, okay, I'm having a second or third occurrence, I've got these symptoms, and what we found is with a lot of our patients and our athletes is that they understand the treatment dynamic that needs to occur. So they don't make the same mistakes over and over again. And by mistakes, I mean returning to play too soon, ignoring symptoms, you know, not seeking professional attention and help when it's needed, thinking that you're just going to recover okay just with time. You know, the benign neglect issue where, you know, I'm just, okay, I know I have a concussion, but I'm not going to see anybody about it because it's going to get better. And unfortunately, that's when we see the protracted recovery issues and folks really struggling with long-term symptoms because they've not received the appropriate care. I think the most important thing for ImPACT to know, and for athletic trainers that are using ImPACT or want to use ImPACT, is that the interaction between the professions and the business end of it is very, very important. Quite often, athletic trainers will do something, they'll buy a program, they'll buy a piece of equipment, and not always take the time to learn how to implement it properly. And I think that that's one of the most important things that ImPACT as a company can do, is to continue to promote the continuing education and the appropriate use of the product. Those of us that are practitioners that are out there using it on a daily basis in the schools and clubs and at the pro level, you know, we still see folks wanting to use it and are motivated to use it appropriately. They're looking for the right answers, but again, without the proper training, don't realize that they're well-intended, but a little bit misinformed. So, and this is where when we talk to athletic trainers, we just remind them constantly, you know, we're stewards of our athletes. We're there for one reason, and it's to protect our players, to make sure that they can compete in a healthy environment. And it's just really important for us as athletic trainers to make sure that if we don't have answers, that we're seeking them out the right way. And again, this is where ImPACT and the webinars have been so important, and you know, and also the courses that are given. I always tell our athletic trainers that are using ImPACT, you know, there's usually a course before the NATA National every year. I highly recommend that because it brings you up to date on what's going on, and you can leave the course knowing that I truly am implementing best practices for my athletes, whether it's at the school site or at the clinic, you know, at the pro level. Concussion management is changing all the time. You know, the technology is going to change every day, but the one thing that's not going to change is the fact that we have to treat our patients. We have to treat our athletes. And in order to do that, we've got to have really sound clinical objective information. And that's what ImPACT does for us. You know, I know a lot of times when people are making decisions about programs to buy and use, you know, there's a lot of people now, a lot of programs because of what's happened in concussion, this booming industry that it's become, that have sort of jumped on the bandwagon. And, you know, we get asked that a lot by some of the school districts and groups that we work with. Gee, Brian, we're thinking about using ImPACT, or we've got this other program. And it really gets back to the reliability clinically and the objective information that we get from ImPACT. And those are the kinds of things, that the talking points that I use when we deal with districts and with risk managers and, you know, the decision makers, because quite often the decision maker is not the one that's going to use the program. You know, they're the purchasing agent for the district, or, you know, and they just know, hey, our medical staff has asked for it, we're gonna buy it. I'm always glad when I hear that. But the next part is my radar is really up, because it's like, okay, let's make sure that you're using it appropriately. And I always remind them that it's easy to use. I mean, they're already used to using computers. They're already, you know, have computer labs in place. There's really nothing other, and we all log on to the internet, onto the web, so it really can't get much simpler than that. And I think now, because of the way ImPACT has evolved through the years, credibility-wise, with the database that's out there, there's just a tremendous amount of scientific evidence that, you know, we need to be using it as a tool. And there's just not another program out there that compares with it that way. And I also like the fact that the program is ever-changing, and that's the other part about the workshops. And to me, that's a big selling point to the school districts. That, you know, this isn't a program and a service that you buy and just walk away from. You know, in order to use it, ImPACT's going to insist that you stay current and that you use it in a way, in a fashion that it's designed. And I know that the districts are buying into that, partly because of the liability issues that are going on right now. And unfortunately, that's when we hear from a lot of school districts. They've had something happen, probably something catastrophic in many cases. That's usually what happens. And then they start looking back at, well, what can we do to prevent this? Or the risk manager at the district is saying, okay, not again. This, we've got to change the policy that we're using. And that's where educating our peer professionals is so important, because it's not only using ImPACT, it's coming up with a plan of care as athletic trainers. You know, and NATA has worked really hard to develop best practices for us. And that's an excellent roadmap. And so a lot of times when we're dealing with school districts, we try to tell them, you know, educate them, look, this is the map that we want you to follow. You know, and it's going to start with having a program that you can use district-wide. You can go right into your computer labs and do. And the other part is making sure you have trained professionals on campus to make sure that they know how to use it appropriately, and that they have access to trained clinicians that understand the information that you're giving them. And you know, the bottom line is that there's not another program out there that's more well-suited to do that for a school district or a club than ImPACT. I'm very fortunate to work at a sports medicine physical therapy practice that has multidisciplinary professionals all under one roof. And I'm the director of sports concussion specialists. We've implemented concussion programs at 6 of our physical therapy practices. And I work as the coordinator navigator of the program. So my biggest role, aside from the community outreach that we do, is to make sure that all of the clinicians that are involved with the care of our athletes coming through concussion clinic understand what we're using, whether it's the equipment that we're using, whether it's ImPACT, our treatment plans, our plans of care, who's doing what, and making sure that we're all on the same page when it comes to what the expected outcome is for this athlete or this patient. And many of the patients that we see are protracted recovery folks. So, you know, there's just been a tremendous learning curve for me as an athletic trainer to understand what these other allied health professionals do. And this is one of the areas that I'm really excited about with regard to the NATA and its interaction with ImPACT, because in order to really use ImPACT correctly, you've got to stay current. And, you know, we're learning things now as athletic trainers and implementing them in our clinics, issues with healing. What's the reason for the protracted recovery issues? So, you know, 4 or 5 years ago, most athletic trainers had no idea what a visual or vestibular problem was. You know, our neuro background was just very limited, because if you look at our curriculum, it's emergent care, it's orthopedic based, because that's traditional athletic training. Now, as we see this field emerging, and you know, concussion is going to be a tremendous field for athletic trainers moving forward. I see it as a wonderful opportunity for folks that really like to get in and work in a multidisciplinary environment. So my situation is probably a little bit unique in that I'm not at a traditional school site or at a university, but I interact with all those folks. You know, and we also are have been providers for Major League Baseball. We see a lot of NFL players that come through, a lot of elite athletes. And, you know, at the first part of our practice a few years ago was pretty much limited to protracted recovery and people that weren't getting better. And we've worked really hard to get out into the community to educate our athletic trainer partners about ways that they can help get their athletes back quicker. And part of it is understanding that there's a role there for the neuropsychologist or the neurooptometrist or the physical therapist that's cross-trained in not only orthopedics, but also understands the comorbidities involved between orthopedic issues, visual and vestibular problems, and how it relates to that 10 or 20% of the population that is going to have protracted recovery, that is going to struggle, and oh, by the way, are not going to do very well in school. That's the whole reason. They're in high school or they're in college. You know, we want to get them back to school, back to a positive learning situation. So athletic trainers are trying to do that. It's a difficult management job for them all by themselves at the school site because they have so many athletes to look after. And, you know, I've been there, I understand their plight, and I think it's really important that athletic trainers do seek out, whether it's a physician's office or, you know, hospitals. There's a lot of emerging concussion clinics around the country, and fortunately, most of them use ImPACT, which is great. So now we can build on a database, and that's the other really important part that we use with our practice. We can treat a patient at our practice in Thousand Oaks or Moore Park and look at their data in Newport Beach and pull in different healthcare providers to help us make decisions about the health and welfare, the progress, where we're going to go with that patient moving forward to get them better. And it's nice to be able to go right on the website and access it that way. So when we talk a little bit about the use of ImPACT and community outreach, it's a wonderful tool that allows us to go out into a community, whether it's a school board or the board of directors for a club, and take our computer with us and actually show them the way ImPACT works. And the other great thing about ImPACT is the fact that we're promoting a treatment paradigm that's just so vital to getting kids better. You know, it's not just take this test, you know, this baseline test, and okay, you're done with that part. Now, if you get hurt, we're going to do this post-injury test, these series of tests. It's also the fact that ImPACT is helping the concussion clinics that are out there promote community outreach through the educational process, the use of the videos, the use of the online courses, the webinars that are, you know, are so important. Those have been wonderful tools for us. To be able to go to a soccer board of directors or a rugby club and as part of our presentation show an ImPACT video. And it's just hard for private insurance or private clinicians to be able to do that, you know, to have the access to that kind of information. So, you know, if we were going to try to put that together just as our own business to build a webinar, build a website, put the videos on there, do all the interactive things that from a marketing and promotion standpoint, not only help promote your practice, but help promote concussion as an emerging field in the sports medicine paradigm of care, we just couldn't do it without the tools that, you know, ImPACT has. And they're all professionally done, so makes a big difference when we're talking to a risk manager or a superintendent from a school or a board of directors of a soccer organization, and we can go in and say, look, you know, this program, when it's used, can take in all of the soccer clubs in Southern California could be using it. All your rugby team, we're not excluding anybody in the process. We want to get as many people baseline tested as possible. And the best place to do that is through the clubs and the schools. And it also can create, I think, some education and awareness for the parents, especially that have kids playing club sports, because a lot of times they have injuries at the club level. And this is something where I really feel for the athletic trainers at the work site, at the school sites, because, you know, just because the high school is a seasonal sport issue, we have kids playing year round. And now they'll get a concussion on a Saturday in a club, you know, lacrosse, soccer, rugby tournament, and go to school on Monday or Tuesday and be in the practice. And now they're symptomatic and they could be having a problem. So standardization, the use of common education and some guidelines is very, very important. And again, from a community outreach standpoint, ImPACT has been very, very helpful. There's some wonderful tools there for the clinician, the marketer to use that they can take to the clubs, to the schools, to the decision makers, and getting to the right people is really important. Quite often when we're dealing with school districts, we see nurses providing care and leadership when it comes to handling the concussed athlete, student athlete on campus. And they definitely have a place in the treatment spectrum. And quite often they're the only ones there, especially in California, where we don't have certified athletic trainers at every school site. So it, generally speaking, the responsibility for the care falls on the school nurse. One of the challenges we have is that sometimes that school nurse is at three or four different schools. So they're not always on campus. They're not there all the time. They don't always see the kids. They don't know the student athletes as well as the athletic trainer might, or even the coaches. So we have had workshops for nurses. They understand the need for some objective clinical information from a baseline standpoint. There's just a lot of room for education there. Some of them embrace ImPACT and really trust it and are biggest advocates for its use on campus. You know, others, depending upon their training, background, and history, don't understand it, and because of the time management issues involved in using it, have sometimes been reluctant to to implement that on campus. I always like talking to the nurses. We have common ground there as athletic trainers, and if we're going representing the hospital, the physician, our practice, you know, our common denominator there is the health and safety of the student athletes. And so as long as we keep orienting it that way, we're finding that there's less resistance to the program. And they're also obligated and bound by legal guidelines. And quite often they view that as a challenge for, you know, starting any new programs, not only because they have to go back and learn how to use it, but also to the implications from a liability and responsibility standpoint. If we're using this, then therefore the assumption is that we're knowledgeable and experts and competent at its use, and therefore going to be held responsible for it. And we just try to tell them that they have support. You know, they've got a team out there. That's where practices like ours are so valuable. California, the CIF stipulates very specifically that a student athlete cannot be returned to play without clearance by an MD or DO that's specialty trained in concussion. And that's been super helpful for us with the school nurses, because we tell them you do have backup. You do have a physician that understands. And fortunately, more and more physicians are embracing the use of ImPACT and embracing the use of multidisciplinary care. They understand that that's the way to go when it comes to managing these problems and these kids with concussions. One of the great things about ImPACT, I think in particular over the last 5 years, has been the CIC program and the quality that brings. As athletic trainer, we know our roles just like our physical therapists do. And I think it's important that professionally people understand that ImPACT has designed the CIC program for a reason. And as such, it's a professional certification that's required. You need to be an MD or a DO or a PhD or a nurse practitioner in order to be a CIC. And there's a reason for that. It's the background and training that's required. Sometimes these cases can get fairly complicated and out of the spectrum of care that we're used to seeing as athletic trainers. I've always been really happy that we have CIC neuropsychologists that we work with. Our program is changing a little bit in that we're now using physicians as our CICs because of the geographic area that our practices cover. We need resources in each one of those areas to help us. But whether it's been our family practice doctors, our pediatricians, our DOs, We've been really, really fortunate to have some great folks working with us as CICs. And the most important part of that is they also understand the role of multidisciplinary care. So it's not just come to me, I'm going to get you better. It's let's look at this as a team and see what we can do to help facilitate proper healing, return to school, return to life, and return to play issues, which is what we all want for our patients. So when we do our education with athletic trainers, whether it's at our seminars or the webinars that we teach, you know, one of the things that we are trying to do is to get the word out to athletic trainers about what really is best practices. And it's not something that was come up just idly. Best practices is something we should all be striving for, whether it's at the professional level, at the collegiate level, or in the high school, or the way we treat our club athletes. And that's where the relationship that ImPACT has as partners with the National Athletic Trainers Association is so vital. It's really important because there's a sharing of knowledge and information there that as an athletic trainer, I might not get access to that kind of information. Depending upon where you were trained, what you were exposed to, you know, the nice thing is that a lot of young athletic trainers coming out have been exposed to ImPACT, and they have been exposed to clinical care that involves a multidisciplinary team. But again, that's where having this interaction is so important. The information that's there, athletic training is an ever-changing profession and science, and we know that's the case with concussion. So learning how to balance those two, and ultimately take better care of your athletes. The school site is traditionally where we as certified athletic trainers work. It's the root of our profession, and that's where we're gonna have the greatest impact on the kids and the athletes that we're seeing, and that's where this relationship is just so important.